Let us go through important questions or questions that have been repeated in multiple previous years' question papers. So these questions should be easily helping you to score 50 marks in the exam. Let's go through them one by one. So first one is partial fractions. Here you'll have two problems coming from 5 marker and one from 3 marker. So 5 marker problem, you'll get something like this, where you have square in the denominator. And in the 3 marker, you will have a simple one like this. So you just have to find x, y, z values using partial fraction method. And you will easily get 8 marks from this. Here, you will be given with this objective function. And then you will be given constraints. All you have to do is plot, get the points, plot them in the graph, get the feasible region, substitute the points in the objective function, and then get the max value or min value based on what they've asked in the question. So this is an easy scorer because there's not much of calculation here. You just have to plot the graph, get the shaded region and get the max and min values. So here you can easily score 5 marks, right? So if you really want to get into details of how linear programming concept works and how to solve the problems, I have created a detailed playlist. You can go through them. Links of each of these chapters will be given in the description box of this video. Next one is mathematical logic. So you get good number of questions in mathematical logic, 1 marker, 2 marker, 3 marker, 5 marker, right? So from the 5 marker section, you will be given proposition, something like this, right? So these are just examples for you to get an idea of how the questions will be. You will be given propositions like this. You'll have to draw the table and determine if it's a tautology, contradiction or neither. This is a simple one. And or probably you will be given propositions. You have to prove that they are logically equivalent. Then there are problems for 1 marks. So you'll be given simple propositions like this with the truth values. You'll have to find the truth value of this compound proposition. And then in 2 marker section, you'll be given 3 propositions, P, Q, R. You'll be given the truth values. You have to find the final truth value. And then in the 3 marker section, you'll be given a proposition like this, right? You'll have to find the converse, inverse and contrapositive. This is an easy scorer, right? Nothing much. You don't have to do any calculations. Don't have to remember any formula. Just have to know how to arrive at converse, inverse and contrapositive. And this is another example of 1 marker. They'll give you propositions. You have to put it in the symbolic form. Very easy. You take this one statement here, call it P. Take another statement here, call it Q and join them with AND. Because AND is given here, join them with AND. So you have to put this in the symbolic form. So it will be P and Q. Simple, right? 1 marker. I've created a detailed playlist on mathematical logic. You can go through them for more understanding. There is a 6 marker in circles, right? In part E, where 4 points will be given. You have to prove that all of these points lie in the circle. That is what is called as concyclic. You have to prove that these points lie on the circle. So what you have to do is take the 3 points, get G, F, C, and then get the equation of the circle. Substitute the 4th point, right? Substitute the 4th point in this equation and prove that it is concyclic. For parabola, you will get 2 markers. So this is straightforward. You will be given the axis. You will be given the point. Just substitute and get the equation. Now in this case, the key thing is you have to determine what kind of parabola it is. Is it upward, downward parabola, left-handed parabola, right-handed parabola? So once you know what kind of parabola it is, you take the equation and substitute this point well. So again, there is a detailed video on parabola. You can refer that. Limits and continuity. So limits and continuity is a large chapter. Now there are multiple kinds of questions that you have in limits, multiple methods, multiple formulas to remember. But continuity is fairly simple, right? It is very simple. This is an easy scorer if you can learn how to get continuity. So in the exercise, there are close to 8 to 9 problems, right? If you can practice them, this will be an easy one. There is detailed videos on limits and continuity in my playlist. You can refer them for understanding. Again, in the limits, right, there is a theorem that you'll have to derive and prove. Either you may get this question of, deriving this theorem or this one, limit theta tending to 0, sine theta by theta is equal to 1. One of these you might get in the exam in part E as a 6 marker question. So if you can understand how this theorem is derived, then you can easily reproduce this in the paper and it's an easy 6 marker because there is no calculation, no formulas, nothing. You just have to write the steps of how this theorem is derived. With 6 marker, you will also be given 4 marker. So along with that limits theorem, right, you will be given a binomial theorem problem. which is a 4 marker. This is nothing but decimal expansion, an easy one. Within 4 to 5 lines, right, within 4 to 5 steps, you'll be able to expand the binomial theorem and get this value. There is one marker in limits, which will come in part A. So this is simple. You just have to, whatever x tending to 3 is given, just substitute this value in this expression and you'll get the value. It will be an easy one mark scorer. Next chapter is learning curve. So here, this is just an example problem, right? You'll have to apply the learning effect and come up with the final cost. Easy 5 marker. Matrices and determinants. Oh, this is a really big chapter, and a lot of questions come from matrices and determinants. I think it's close to 23 marks that you get from matrices and determinants. So this chapter, I think you'll have to put focus, because it's a high scorer and a lot of questions come from this chapter. So you have questions in the 1 marker, 2 marker, 3 marker, 5 marker category, even 6 marker. So there are questions in all the parts for matrices. So for 3 marker, you'll have something like this, right? You will be given matrices and you'll have to prove this kind of statement, right? Or you have to prove this one. In 2 marker section, you will have to find X and Y. Another one is something like this. You have given 2 matrices. You have to find A-3B or A-3B, A-4B, A-2B, anything. These are all 1 marker examples. If A is this, then find 2A, find 3A, find X. This is a matrix. So these are simple ones. Then there is a 6 marker problem. You'll have to solve it using matrix method. You'll have to get the inverse, you'll have to get the adjoint, you'll have to get the determinant, multiply the matrices and find X, Y, Z values. So either you can get a word problem like this, right? Where you'll have to, you know, from the word problem, you'll have to find out and get the equation. Or you might be directly given something like this, right? You'll be given 3 equations. You'll have to get matrix A, matrix B and matrix X. And you have to find X, Y, Z values using matrix method. Then another one we have seen is solve by Cramer's rule, right? This is another 3 marker. So there is an easy trick to multiply matrices, because normally we do mistakes when we multiply matrices. There is an easy way, and I've given a trick on that. These are simple 1 markers, right? So first one is from stocks and shares. First one is a simple scorer, right? They'll tell what income can be obtained from a X amount given percentage, right? This one can be done. Then in trigonometry, we can score this easily, this 1 marker once in the trigonometry. If tan A is something, find tan 2A. If sin A is something, find cos 2A. Maybe if you can try to remember the tan 2A formulas, cos 2A formulas, sin 2A formulas, then you can easily get this 1 markers. Then another one is from permutations and combinations, right? So in 2 marker section, any word can be given, right? It can be Monday, Karam, committee, anything. You just have to find the number of ways that this particular word can be arranged. This is again an easy one. Again, permutations and combinations, there are different problem times, and sometimes it can appear slightly confusing, because we will not know when to apply multiplication, when to do addition, when to use permutation formula, when to use combinations formula. So for that, again, there is detailed playlist created where you can quickly differentiate between when to use what. So practice that and this will be an easy scorer. Next is ratio and proportions. Ratio and proportions, you have quick 2 marker and 1 markers, which you can easily solve. Finding the value given this proportion. Then what can be added to each term so that it becomes 8:9 ratio, something like this. And then you can, how to find the duplicate ratio, how to find the triplicate ratio, right? You just take 2 square, 3 square, it becomes duplicate ratio. Take 3 cube and 4 cube, it becomes triplicate ratio. And there is one which related to probability. This is a simple 2 marker one. So they'll give you probability of B or probability of A or probability of A and B. And then you have to find the probability of A by B or B by A. So this is again an easy 2 marker. And this is something related to circular permutations. How many people can be seated around a table? So totally 60 plus marks related questions. So if you can practice these topics thoroughly, you can easily score 50 marks. For more information on each of these topics, right, you can look at the links in the description. I will give links to the playlist. And also, there are solved question papers from the previous years. You can refer that. You can also refer the model question paper that has been solved. All of the links will be given in the description. Thanks for watching. Hope this was helpful.